In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Good afternoon. Today we celebrate the Father's Day. So, happy Father's Day. And after a long time, maybe 2 months, 2.5 months, you know, we have coming together to celebrate on Sunday. Let's thank God for His graciousness. Thank God for His blessing. As we come around this Eucharist table, let us thank God for all His benefits. And today's gospel speaks about, do not be afraid. And as we prepare to celebrate the sacred mysteries, today's Mass intentions, thanksgiving for Rene and Paz de Leon and Jose Oliveira Jr. and all souls in purgatory. As we gather around this Eucharist table, let's be aware of our shortcomings, failures, and ask the Lord pardon and strength. And say, I confess to Almighty God and to my brothers and sisters that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts, in my words, in what I have done, in what I have failed to do, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and to my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to Lord of God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy.
Glory to God in the highest. Glory, glory to God. And on earth, peace to people, people of good will. We praise you. Son of the Father, you tell You take away the sins of the world. Receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Have mercy on us. Glory, glory to God. Glory to God in the highest. Glory, glory to God. And on earth, peace to people, people of good will. For you alone are the Holy One. You alone are Christ with the Holy Spirit in the glory of God the Father. Glory, glory to God. Glory to God in the highest.
Let us pray. Grant, O Lord, that we may always revere and love your holy name, for you never deprive of your guidance those you set firm on the foundation of your love. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
A reading from the book of the prophet Jeremiah. Jeremiah cried out, "I hear many whispering. Terror is all around. Denounce him. Let us denounce him. All my close friends are watching for me to stumble. Perhaps he can be enticed, and we can prevail against him and take our revenge on him. But the Lord is with me, like a dread warrior. Therefore, my persecutors will stumble, and they will not prevail. They will be greatly shamed, for they will not succeed. Their eternal dishonor will never be forgotten. O Lord of hosts, you test the righteous. You see the heart and the mind. Let me see your retribution upon them, for to you I have committed my cause. Sing to the Lord, praise the Lord, for he has delivered the life of the needy from the hands of evildoers." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
In your great love, answer me, O God. In your great love, answer me, O God. It is for you that I suffer taunts, that shame covers my face, that I have become a stranger to my family. sisters. I burn with zeal for your house, and taunts against you fall on me. In your great love, answer me, O God. This is my prayer to you, my prayer for your favor. In your great love, answer me, O God, with your help that never fails. Lord, answer, for your love is kind. In your compassion, turn towards me.
In your great love, answer me, O God.
The poor, when they see it, will be glad, and God-seeking hearts will revive. For the Lord listens to the needy, and does not spurn his servants in their chains. Let the heavens and the earth give him praise, the sea and all its living creatures.
In your great love, answer me, O God.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, just as sin came into the world through one man, and death came through sin, so death spread to all people because all have sinned. Sin was indeed in the world before the law, but sin is not reckoned when there is no law. Yet death exercised dominion from Adam to Moses, even over those whose sins were not like the transgressions of Adam, who is a type of the one who was to come. But the free gift is not like the trespass. For if the many died through the one man's trespass, much more surely have the grace of God and the free gift in the grace of the one man, Jesus Christ, abound for the many. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Let us all please rise for the gospel acclamation.
With you
and with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Jesus said to his apostles, "Fear no one, for nothing is covered up that will not be uncovered, and nothing secret that will not become known. What I say to you in the dark, tell in the light, and what you hear whispered, proclaim from the housetops. Do not fear those who kill the body, but cannot kill the soul. Rather, fear him who can destroy both soul and body in hell. Are not two sparrows sold for a penny? Yet not one of them will fall to the ground apart from your Father. And even the hairs of your head are all counted. So do not be afraid. You are of more value than many sparrows. Everyone, therefore, who acknowledges me before humans, I also will acknowledge before my Father in heaven. But whoever denies me before humans, I also will deny before my Father in heaven." The Gospel of the Lord.
Straight from the heart. My dear brothers and sisters in Christ, one day people of Gubbio in Italy went to San Francisco of Assisi and told him about a wolf that attacks and kill their animals, their people. The saint told them that he will come and rebuke the wolf. But the people reported him that wolf was very ferocious. Next day, Saint Francis went to the place. When the wolf sees Saint Francis, he comes charging at the saint with his mouth open, ready to attack. Saint Francis immediately makes a sign of cross over the wolf and says, "Come here, brother wolf. I command you on behalf of Christ that you do no harm to me or anyone else." As soon as Saint Francis did this, the fearsome wolf closed his mouth and stopped running. And once the command was given, the wolf came meekly as a lamb and threw itself at the feet of Saint Francis. Saint Francis fiercely went to the wolf because he considered the wolf as a brother. My dear brothers and sisters in Christ, today's gospel says, do not be afraid. Do not fear. Today I thought of sharing something about fear. When I say about fear, there is a butterfly in my stomach because it's my first day here and I don't know how you are going to take my homily, you know, a kind of a fear. But, you know, we have seen how the relationship between St. Francis and the wolf. Because St. Francis grown into the freedom of a child of God. And he could relate everyone, everything on this earth, universe, brother and sister. So he was able to connect, make a relationship with the wolf and say, "Brother wolf, come here, do not attack." And the story tells, you know, they made a contract between wolf and the people of the Gubbio in Italy, that they will be providing food for the wolf. And today, when we hear the passage of gospel passage, Jesus tells three times, do not be afraid, do not fear. And fear in itself is negative. It pulls us back from doing good. But you know, in the book of Proverbs, chapter 9, verse 10 says, fear of God is the beginning of wisdom. I'm just, you know. So, Bible says fear is good enough. And psychologists say that a little fear helps to prepare for the event, prepare for exam, prepare for the program. Fear makes precaution to enable the person to overcome the dangerous situations, different difficulty and difficult moments. And today's gospel is telling us, you need to grow into the freedom of a child of God, to acknowledge, to witness Jesus in your life. The moment we acknowledge Jesus, the moment we acknowledge God in our life, God will be acknowledging us. The fear, you know, fear makes us dull, down, pulls us back from doing good things. But the moment when we come out of fear, when we overcome fear, we will be very confident. When we are confident, we will be doing better. Our performance will be better. When our performance become better, our satisfaction, our contentment, our joy will be more or greater. And if our fear is overcoming us, you know, there will be tension. There will be anxiety. You know, there will be nervous breakdown. We may not be able to do anything at all. And today's gospel speaks, you know, fear not. Do not be afraid. Trust in the Lord. Hope in the Lord. Acknowledge Him. And He will acknowledge you. And my dear brothers and sisters, keep fear away. A little fear, of course, fear of God is the beginning of wisdom. That fear will prepares you better. A little fear makes you take precautions. And we are all fearful in a way because of COVID-19. We need to take precautions. We need to prepare ourselves. And we will be confident. When we are confident, we will be doing our performance better. And there will be greater joy, a greater satisfaction, and greater contentment. Amen. Let us profess our faith. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth, and Jesus Christ, His only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day, He rose again from the dead. He ascended to heaven and seated at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From there, He will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. We are a people signed with the sign of the cross. We pray that we may live according to the promise of resurrection embedded in that cross.
For the grace of true discipleship, that we may have the courage to reject the short-term glamour of self-indulgence and consumerism and spend our lives in loving service of those whom we encounter daily, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the grace of patience, that we may face the sufferings of life with the assurance that Christ is always with us, we pray to the Lord.
We hear our prayers.
For the gift of understanding, that we may allow Christ's question to challenge us and lead us to a new understanding of Him and our relationship with Him, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For our government leaders, federal, provincial, and municipal, that God will give them insight and courage as new policies are developed and priorities are established, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who experience the cross of discipleship, particularly those who are persecuted or imprisoned for their faith, that God will give them courage and hope as they endure pain and hardship, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For all who lay down their lives for the life of others, particularly parents and those caring for the sick and elderly, that God will renew them and give them strength and courage, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For God's creation, that God will guide us in protecting the air, land, and water that we share, so that all may benefit from God's gifts, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For our fathers, who have given us life and love, that we may show them respect and love, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For fathers who have lost a child through death, that their faith may give them hope, and their family and friends support and console them, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For fathers who have died, that God may bring them into the joy of His kingdom, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers. God, who has promised us the life of the resurrection, give us the courage to face the cross, deny ourselves, and follow You. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Please be seated.
Shelter of the Lord, who abide in His shadow for life. Say to the Lord, my refuge, my rock in whom I trust, and He will raise you up on eagle's wings. Shine like the sun and hold you in the palm of His hand, and He will raise you up on eagle's wings, bear you on the breath. shine like the sun and hold you in the palm of his hand.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness, we have received the bread we offer you. Fruit of the earth and work of human hands will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness, we have received the wine we offer you. Fruit of the wine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink. With a humble spirit and contrite heart, may we be accepted by you, O Lord. And may the sacrifice in your sight this day be pleasing to you, Lord God. Lord, wash me from iniquity and cleanse me from my sin. Pray, my dear brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Receive, O Lord, the sacrifice of conciliation and praise, and grant that, cleansed by its action, we may take offering of a heart pleasing to you, through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let's give thanks, Lord of God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For through his paschal mystery, he accomplished the marvelous deed by which he has freed us from the yoke of sin and death, summoning us to the glory of being now called a chosen race, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, a people for your own possession, to proclaim everywhere your mighty works, for you have called us out of darkness into your own wonderful light. And so, with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dew fall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed, and entered willingly into his passion. He took bread and, giving thanks, broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Thomas, our bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. We especially remember Jose Oliveira Jr. and souls in purgatory. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, "Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil." Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to the apostles, "I leave you peace. My peace I give you. Look not on sins, but on the faith of your church, and grant us the peace and unity of your kingdom, verily for ever and ever. Amen. Peace of the Lord be with you always. Peace with you. Peace with you.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy. Take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Oh, grant us, peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Happy are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should unbar my roof, but only say the word, my soul shall be healed. May the body of our Lord Jesus Christ keep me safe for eternal life. Amen.
In order to facilitate the distribution of Holy Communion, I will ask Deacon Michael to be standing beside the statue of the Blessed Mother, and Father Jason will be standing in the middle. We will ask those who are coming to Father Jason to please just that side for at first, and then only after everybody has received communion on that side, that we will give communion here on this side. Please note that on the floor, there are yellow markings or arrows which indicate where you're going to walk. Please maintain social distance as you come up for Holy Communion. And for those of you, the three of you, you probably just have to go around, okay? And that will help us in the facilitate matters for all of us.
You shall cross the barren desert, but you shall not die. shall wander far in safety, though you do not know the way. You shall speak your words in foreign lands, and all will understand. You shall see
Let us pray. Renewed and nourished by the sacred body and precious blood of your Son, we ask of your mercy, O Lord, that what we celebrate with constant devotion may be our sure pledge of redemption. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Please be seated. First of all, I'd like to greet all the fathers who are here present, as well as those who are joining us in this Holy Mass online. And the announcement, Father Jason is going to give a special blessing to all the fathers in our communities. I'd like to welcome Father Jason into our community. Father Jason with an I, insists, Jason with an I. He is a Capuchin father, and he will be celebrating many of our masses here in the church. So let us give him a big welcome. You know, I've been praying to our Blessed Mother under her title, Mary, Help of Christians, when, you know, shortly before we opened the church, and I said, how can we be able to address the needs of our community when we can only limit so many people inside the church, and, you know, there's so many of us, and he is the answer to prayer. So I'm very, very grateful for that. You know, because immediately following that novena that I made to Our Lady of Perpetual Help, I got a phone call from him. I didn't even know from Adam that he is a priest. So, but then he just called me up here and presented himself. So somebody must be listening up there. So I'm very, very grateful for Father Jason for thinking of us here at St. Josephine Bakhita. I'd like to ask you, we've tried our best to keep it simple, straightforward, the reservation of seats, but if you know anybody who have no access to a computer or don't know how to access the computer or their mobile device, please help them so they're able to come to Mass. While they can always call up the parish office, I cannot guarantee that somebody is here to answer the phone because, as you know, we are still in the midst of COVID-19, and just like any of the many employees today, they are working remotely, so they may not be able to attend to the request. So if you know anybody who would like to come to church, if you can help them to secure their reserve seats, please help them. The other thing is we are, because of this pandemic, there are many, many things that are required in order to keep all of us safe. And so we will need as many volunteers as is possible. So, for example, after this Mass is over, we're going to disinfect the seats, And I'm very grateful for people like Serge Poye who have been so generous in volunteering their time. He was here since 7:30 in the morning, and still here. So we need people like him to offer their help in order to facilitate matters. Try to serve in any way you can. In whatever capacity you are comfortable with. There is this parable in the gospel of the 10 wise, the 10 virgins. Okay, 5 were wise and 5 were foolish. Which one are you? When Mass begins, we will close the doors of the church, so nobody is allowed to come in while Mass is going on. And in that way, we can keep everybody safe and healthy. So, you know, in the parable of the 10 virgins, 10 of them were all waiting for the bridegroom to arrive. When the bridegroom arrived, 5 were only allowed in, and the other 5 were not allowed in. So we say there were 5 wise virgins and there were 5 foolish virgins. I suppose you are wise virgins because you were able to come on time here. But if you were late for one reason or the other and we have started Mass, well, you know, you're out of luck. So I would ask that you please make it a habit from now on to come on time if you'd like to be able to join us for Holy Mass here at the church. These are some of the things that we're trying to put into place in order to keep everybody safe. All our Masses are streamed online, are available online on our YouTube channel. So if you're not comfortable coming to church, you can always follow the Mass along. All our Masses, even weekday Masses, are all streamed live. Okay, so if you feel that you are not comfortable coming to church, don't feel guilty. You can still participate in the prayers of the community. Okay, so at this time, I'd like to... Oh, one last item. After the Mass is over, you can exit through the doors of this inside this church, and the narthex is for you to come in if you'd like to join us for worship. We did not also pass the basket as we used to do, so we have put boxes on the door and. Where when you came in, you probably see those donation boxes. Those are for your offerings if you'd like to support the church monetarily. I was joking with my cousin in the States yesterday because she asked me the question, so are you going to pass the basket at the offertory? And I said, no, we have boxes at the door of the church as people come in. And I believe she said to me, what is that? Pay before you pray? So, what can I do? You know, so we're in pandemic time. we have to make all the necessary adjustments. But in any case, if you'd like to help, just drop your donation there, and it will be, we are very grateful for that support. At this time, I'd like to invite you to please stand. Let us, Father Jason, to give us the final blessing.
The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. Our Mass is ended. Go in the peace of Christ. Now, today we especially pray for fathers. Though he is not a physical father, our Father Mark, we call Father Mark, am I right? So you need to wish him. Maybe may not be physically, it is not advised, but if there are social medias to wish him, please do, because he's a father. And just want to say a prayer for blessing for the fathers, and let us pray. God our Father, in your wisdom and love, you made all things. Bless these fathers that they may be strengthened as Christian fathers. Let the example of their faith and love shine forth. Grant that we, their sons and daughters, may honor them always with a spirit of proud respect. Grant this through Christ our Lord. And may Almighty God bless you all, Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. And once again, Happy Father's Day. And in appreciation, let us give a round of applause. God bless you.
Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved and strengthened me. I once was lost, but now am found, was blind, but now I see. 'Twas grace that taught my heart to fear, and grace my fear.